Yeah, and I mean, it just grew so much. But what can you love more than a whole convention dedicated to Smash?
Yeah.
Every single game to watch, but we're going to get right into this next set. We got Riddles, the best Belmont player in the world, hailing from Canada, and of course, Kool-Aid coming from that New England.
Yeah, no doubt about it, man. New England is just full of a lot of talented fellas. I'm not just talking about your standard guys, you know, Mars and Light. Hey, Kool-Aid, he's up there with the best as well. You know what I'm saying? Don't forget about my boy Raffy. Don't forget about Pelka. New England has a lot of talented individuals who we don't often get to see put on display. But I'll tell you what, Kool-Aid, man, he's going to surprise a lot of people in this bracket, I guarantee you.
Oh, yeah, and he's just been a vet ever since Brawl. And yep. Let me tell you, I honestly think New England is actually the strongest region in the world.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
If we're just talking about, you have two top 10 players, and I'm not about that Japan counts as an entire region. That is a country. That
That's
is
true.
A entire country.
I recently learned there's an East and West.
Yeah.
That way big as hell. Crazy.
Yeah, it's pretty insane. But of course, I mean, and we just talk about that because Kool-Aid is from there. So, and I know Riddles is the best Belmont, but Belmont's definitely a character that has a very exploitable weakness. That recovery, not the greatest in the game for sure.
Facts. You know, I've seen Riddles a couple times, man. I know this guy can definitely get down with the get downs. So he's no easy out by any means. And right now, just doing an excellent job to display the pressure, everything kind of working out for him.
Oh, yeah. And the thing about Belmont, too, is they don't have the greatest recovery. But look at this man recover against Lucina, a character that time and time again we have said has one of the best offstage games in the entire game.
I expect Kool-Aid to be a little familiar with this matchup. I know Hazmat played a lot of Belmonts towards the beginning, and I know they play together all the time. So
yes.
And Hazmat far from a slouch, but right now, Riddle's able to take that first stock off of Kool-Aid. It could be one of those things too. Hey, I haven't seen this character in a long time. You got to kind of remember as you go.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, the Belmont's definitely, in my opinion, the character that has the strongest ledge trapping in the game. You essentially have that Arc Fire EX being the holy water.
And right.
You just have so many crazy setups and traps on the ledge. And then he actually has like shield break things. And like, oh, if you hang on too long, I can F smash you. It's insane how much options this character has when they're ledge pressuring.
Definitely, man. A ton of good things going for this character. And some good things going for Kool-Aid as well as he started to kind of pick it up, definitely cut into that deficit he was facing, actually assumed the lead momentarily, and that could have been deadly. That air dodge right there, if
yes.
Kool-Aid had just been a little more prepared, he could have really exploited that recovery.
Oh man, the call out on the up air. Kool-Aid is almost going to get taken off
wow.
the top, but the hunt continues with
oh,
Riddles.
Oh my goodness, so many change. You might think you're watching Django.
But
real
but
out here.
It's crazy. And the thing about getting juggled by Belmont is that up air is very long, but it doesn't have a lot of width. So there's like a dead zone within that area of like the angled up back air or forward air and that up air. And that's where you want to stay. But Riddles is not making it easy here for Kool-Aid.
Off to him, man. Kind of what, and you know, again, I'm very familiar with Riddles. He's a very talented player. He had a really good run at Pound as well. I remember watching
yep.
him compete at that event too. So good to see him back in the MDBA area. And he's having a lot of success right now. Kool-Aid is getting absolutely decimated. I hate to say it, but it's
yep.
on the screen.
And this is a very common thing with this character. We got the forward smash. That dash grab, pretty greedy from Riddles, honestly. Because, I mean, dash grab is so laggy in this game. It
yeah.
is definitely like you are very confident in the shield. He is going to lose a stock, and this is where it gets scary, man. If the stocks are even, anyone can take it versus Belmont just because it's so volatile.
Right, exactly. And Lucina, obviously pretty darn good once you get you off stage.
Oh,
ooh, that holy water.
He grabbed the holy water, though.
He's capping.
Okay,
you don't believe.
Wow.
You don't believe. He was capping. He didn't believe.
Yeah.
Put that
yeah.
water down, son.
Yeah. He was just like, wow, I actually got it. do I really have this holy water? And it's actually funny because Riddles is so confident in that situation. He was like, yeah, you're going to normal get up and throw it, and I'm literally just going to kill you for it. Like, you actually caught the water, which is hype, because I'm going to kill you for throwing it.
That was so good, man.
Man, and this, he's so young. Riddles is very young. I believe he's like 17.
He's one of those kids who kind of, you can almost kind of put in the potential of a prodigy
yes.
type.
Oh,
you know
yes.
what I mean? That kind of feel, because it's the young bucks. When they're hitting, man, they hit hard.
Oh, right? Yeah. And these youngins, man, they got some reaction. And let me tell you something. Reactions is something you need in this game.
Come on, that's coming from two old people. We can attest to that, all right?
I'm a wolf main for a reason.
My man, listen. I ain't never heard a more honest statement in my life on the mic, all right? Preach it, baby, preach it.
Yeah, and I mean, Riddles is so, it's crazy because this kid's doing so much
yeah.
with a character that some people put in bottom five. This character is it's just crazy because this character can either just look so broken or look not so broken just because it's like, oh, I'm just going to give him. But wow, Kool-Aid hasn't taken a single percent.
Because Kool-Aid is going back to his roots right now, okay? He's going back to the Pac-Man army, baby. He done unlisted everybody. I'm talking about Hydra, Galaga, the Bell. I know they're not people, but goddamn it, they hit like you know. What's it? Pinky, Inky, and Stinky? Is that who them boys are who roll with him? Either way, man.
That's a squad.
Whole damn squad.
Now, like you said, his roots. Kool-Aid was also known in Smash 4 for the Pac-Man. Yep. He also did play a nice, very nice Sheik, but he did have a Pac-Man. Wasn't so great in Smash 4, just the character in general, but has received a ton of buffs coming into Ultimate, and we see so many great players doing so well with Pac-Man. We see T and Sinji just getting so many Ws, and now Kool-Aid wants to come in and be like, yo, can I add my name to the list?
I think you absolutely can. You know, in New England, no stranger to Pac-Man, as you just said, Kool-Aid with the history there. Kiwi actually residing in New England as well. She's very talented, no doubt about it. So New England definitely holding it down. And I'll tell you what, this switch has been night and day, a total turnaround for Kool-Aid. He is dominating Riddles.
Yeah, and that's the thing, like with Lucina, the gimps come even, gimps come easy. Yeah. But, you know, Kool-Aid wasn't getting any of those gimps. So I really like the switch that he's like, you know what, I'm not getting any gimps. Oh, the up here, okay. He wasn't getting any gimps, and the neutral can be hard. You know, you're trying to play this mid-range, which is where Belmonts want to play.
I feel that.
So now Kool-Aid's like, you know what? I'm a take my neutral a little bit farther back.
I love the efficiency that Kool-Aid is playing with.
Right? Oh, my, that apple was so good. Yeah. Went right over the holy water, just sniped him out, and he's still alive.
He just had the perfect angle. And yes, as you said, still alive. 116 for Kool-Aid. However, Riddles, he's in a lot of trouble. 173, this is a very unforgiving percent, and obviously you run headfirst into that key, man, and it did not budge.
And you already know Kool-Aid's just like, well, you know what? It was pretty close when I had to go to you, but how about we play a little game? How about you try to get to me? And it is working out tenfold here for Kool-Aid. He's still got 3 stocks in the tank, bro.
Being on the opposite side is never fun, my friend, but
oh yeah, for sure.
Here it is nonetheless.
You're whipping out and
what a response for Kool-Aid if he gets this 3-stock, man. I'm not trying to call it, but good lord.
And I love it. The hydrant is gonna be a great tool. It might not get the gimp because the angle flies high, but you know, Belmonts always want to sink to that level. All right. Riddle's like, you know what? That Pac-Man nice. But you ain't 3-stocking me on stream, bro.
I mean, I'll give him that. He was able to respond, able to get the stock off, but you gotta imagine it's too little too late for this particular game, man. He's at 93 on his final stock. Kool-Aid is playing like he wants all that and then some.
Yeah, and even like Riddles in those situations where he was juggling with Richter, he can't really do that against Pac-Man because look at that hydrant. Yeah. It comes right down. It's a projectile that you have to respect. Okay, now going high, and look, I love that Kool-Aid keeps forcing the high recoveries or just the high in disadvantage because he has that hydrant to throw down.
It's making it so much easier to just get that percent up and get that punish game. You see he ends up winning these situations 9 times out of 10.
Yeah, and exactly. It's like Riddles throws out the holy water, and Kool-Aid doesn't have to really care about it. It's like, okay, I can play outside of the range of holy water. I can, like, just charge up my key, go right through it. Like, I'm chilling right now. And he also has the stock lead as well.
Big chilling. 136 for Riddles. If ever there was a time for a miracle, it is now because Kool-Aid is showing no signs of letting this game get away from him.
Yeah, exactly. Kool-Aid knows what got him to this point. He's sticking to the game plan here. Very nice forward here. The melon gonna hop right over that here for Riddles, and another ledge trap. He has to nail it here. Oh man! Oh, the grab though. This could be the stock.
Okay, yeah, I think it might be. Yes, sirree. Right on cue. So unlikely but possible. You know.
Yeah, I mean,
be fair about this.
He definitely ain't giving Pac-Man.
That was so good. He waited for that roll, bro. That was pure anticipation.
Oh yeah. And I mean, that's when you know you're confident, right? Yeah. It's just like, man, I got this guy so shook. Trying to use the apple to get the stock, but the holy water, man, saving him. And a parry on the apple as well. Really trying to force this apple approach, but why not? It's all safe. Kool-Aid hasn't taken a single percent for going for these stocks.
He's been perfectly fine thus far, and I think that's what can really start to get frustrating.
Wait a minute. Okay, so right now the Belmont does have a full tank of rage. The back throw? Oh, no, up throw? Maybe just saving it. Wow.
No way. Are you serious?
No way.
Oh, my God.
What?
The most unlikely comeback perhaps we've seen all weekend. Riddles, let me tell you, it's ironic you call him Riddles because that boy didn't have a clue.
Riddle,
he didn't know this was going to happen.
Baby.
He didn't know. But damn it, in the moment, if he didn't take advantage of it.
Oh, my Lord. Whoa. And Riddles with the pop-off. I robbed you.
Kool-Aid, yes. Lay, Kool-Aid Lay just lost custody of his kids, man. I feel so bad.